first and 10. Wants it all. Deep over the middle for Winicky. Has it inside the 10. Still with it. Diana Powerball. Ilfil Velez on the run. Diving in the alley.
It's Alexander with a nice move. Goes to the rim. Got it to go.
Hi, friends, and welcome inside Frost Arena, home to the South Dakota State men's and women's basketball teams, also home this past week to the Class A State South Dakota Girls High School Basketball Tournament. And this week, it's also home to the Jackrabbit Insider. I'm Tyler Merriam. It is great to have you with us this week, and we have a lot to talk about on the heels of Championship Week. SDSU, with its first ever Big 12 wrestling champion, Seth Gross, will highlight their time in Tulsa, Oklahoma, coming up. The SDSU women are postseason bound. We'll recap their performance in the Summit League tournament. And at the end of the show, a special feature you do not want to miss, recapping the Summit League championship for the SDSU men. But first things first, a game-by-game recap of how the Jacks won their fourth Summit League tournament in 6 years. Against Denver in the opening round, the Jacks faced an early 7-4 deficit. Then the Blue Squad rattled off 10 straight. Reed Tellinghuysen hit three from deep in the span of 3 minutes and 6 seconds, state by eight. Then it was Mike Dom, the conference player of the year, who would contribute from both inside and outside. A 17-6 onslaught, and the Jacks carried a 7-point lead into halftime. To start the second, three straight scores by Chris Howell, Tellinghuysen, and Dom had SDSU up 13, and the game was never in doubt from there. Dom had 33, Tellinghuysen 18 points and 9 rebounds. The final, SDSU 83, Denver 73. The semifinals pitted the Jacks against rival USD in a crowd of 11,235, the most to ever see a basketball game in South Dakota, turned out and witnessed a classic. Reed Tellinghuysen scored the opening bucket, but the Coyotes tied it just 10 seconds later and dominated the rest of the first half. First team All-League selection Matt Mooney had 16 in the opening 20 minutes, and USD sported a 44-33 lead at the break. Down 13 with 13:31 left, Lane Severin starts the rally with a putback. Then Skylar Flatten with a big three. And Dom cuts the lead to six, a 7-0 Jacks run in less than 2 minutes. Michael Orris had the game of his life, and this three drew the Jacks within 58-55 with just under 10 left. Howell's two with six to play cut the USD lead to one. But Mooney, who hit so many big shots on this night, connects from three to put USD in front 68-65 with two to go. The game is now tied, 34 seconds left, and it's Mooney from three, and the Coyotes lead by three. Now Dom on the other end gets fouled and converts a pair of free throws, and the Jacks would foul freshman Tyler Peterson. With USD in front 71-70 and 13 seconds left, the free throw is no good. So Orris dribbles down the floor. He can't find Dom, and with no other option, he calmly buries the jumper with a second and a half to play. He tied his career high with 20. State led for exactly 11 and a half seconds, but it was enough. SDSU on to the finals, a 74-71 win over the regular season champion USD.
Our play broke down and we didn't get exactly what we drew up. And so ball was in my hands, knew I had to make a play, so saw my opportunity and made it.
The Jacks turned their season around with a road win at Omaha, so it was fitting that in order to make the NCAA tournament, they'd have to finish it against that same Maverick squad. And Omaha was swinging haymakers early. Tradeon Hollins, Trayshawn Thurman, and Mitch Hahn all hit threes as Omaha built a 9-point lead in the opening minutes. But the Jacks' defense rose up, and SDSU cleaned up its act offensively. Ian Tyson had a huge few minutes off the bench, including this three. Flatten tied the game from deep. And with six to play in the first, Tellinghuysen's bomb gave State its first lead. But this was a game to be decided down the stretch. 13 lead changes, 8 ties, a physical, athletic game that in the end was decided by the Summit League Player of the Year. Dom made 14 of his 24 attempts, 5 of his 9 threes. He tallied 12 rebounds, and he scored 37 points in 34 minutes of playing time. The Jacks trailed by 4 with 5 to go before Dom scored 7 straight. And Howell's bucket put State up 5 with a minute 59 left. Ahead by 2, the Jacks would need to survive one more Omaha possession. Hollins' 3 was long, and SDSU won its 4th Summit League title in 6 years, a 79-77 victory.
Just really proud of these guys and how they've come together and how they've persevered through all adversity through the year. And I think, again, these games are very representative of our season, and couldn't be happier to be the coach here, these great guys.
Congratulations to T.J. Otzelberger and the South Dakota State men's basketball team, 4th Summit League championship over the last 6 seasons. Coming up next, a recap of the SDSU wrestling team at the Big 12 championships, including their first ever individual conference champion. We'll send you to Tulsa after we take you inside state.
My name is Kristen Olk, and I'm the Assistant Director of the First Year Advising Center. We are with University College, and I primarily work with first-year students who are transitioning to the university from home, who maybe are deciding in their major, or who are pursuing a degree in the Agricultural and Biological College. I also work with students who may be readmitted to the university or on academic probation. That's tough because I'm an ice cream junkie. There's a newer ice cream over there that's coffee, cookies and cream, and a past student of mine actually created that flavor. So I'm all in. How exciting, right? I got to go over and be part of like the taste testing, and it was pretty cool. So if I see that there, I usually get it because I'm thinking, you made this, I should have this. I have a lot of trinkets on my desk because I'm a fidgeter by nature, and so a lot of my students are too. So they can play with those magnets, they can take it off there, there's the stars underneath there, they can stack up. So I think with first year students, a lot of times you feel like you're leaving your home base, right? I feel like it's a pretty strong metaphor actually for your first year of college, just spreading your wings and seeing what happens. So sometimes when I'm meeting with students and they're struggling or they're just like needing a little pick-me-up, I bring out my handy-dandy words of wisdom because I'm really not the wisest person, but these people are. You know, shoot me a page number between 1 and 618. This is what it says. It says, figure out the criteria with which to measure your life. Wisdom from the book. You know, what I love most about the SDSU student and what I talk to my family and my friends about and prospective students is how engaged they are. I think a lot of our students come from smaller areas, so they're used to being really involved. They're used to being on student council. They're used to being in sports. They're used to standing up for what's right, standing up for the little guy. And so I'm really energized by how active our student body is and how students, they look out for each other here. They know that they have a responsibility to each other just as much as they do to themselves.
Back in the corner, left alone for the 3 ball, and she has got it.
It's like a shooting drill right now.
Horniman, I'm telling you, 25-4.
Listen up. This is the time, this is the place, and this is Ford F-150, the truck that goes toe-to-toe with your life. Made of high-strength, military-grade aluminum alloy, it pulled the highest safety rating the government can give. And with Pro Trailer Backup Assist, it's like having your head on a swivel, pal. So load up your crew. This is the time.
Now get up to $10,395 in total savings or lease an F-150 for just $279 a month. Visit your local Northland Ford dealer today.
How did we become the region's largest independent seed company? By taking a very simple but powerful stand. We will sell no seed that we wouldn't be happy to plant on our own farm. Peterson Farm Seed. Stand tall.
Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. For powerful calls. For breakthrough calls. For professional calls. For tough calls. For unexpected calls. for expert calls. Make the right call. Choose the experts. Choose Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine.
This portion of the Jackrabbit Insider is brought to you by Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. Expert care when you need it.
Welcome back to the Jackrabbit Insider. We are inside Frost Arena here on the SDSU campus. And this past week, Chris Bono and the SDSU wrestling team continued its climb towards the tops in all of Division I as the Jackrabbit wrestlers had five qualify for the NCAA championships, highlighted by Big 12 champion Seth Gross. Let's take you back to Tulsa, Oklahoma. Seth Gross led the wrestlers to a third-place finish in the BOK Center in Tulsa, Oklahoma, at last weekend's Big 12 Wrestling Championships. Gross was one of five Jacks who earned automatic berths into this week's NCAA Division I Wrestling Championships in St. Louis. More on that momentarily. Gross, a sophomore from Apple Valley, Minnesota, beat Oklahoma State's Cade Brock by decision 9-7 to win the 133-pound championship. It's SDSU's first Big 12 title in just the Jacks' second year as an affiliate member of the league. David Kosher at 174 and 184-pounder Martin Mueller each went 3-1, finishing third in their respective weight classes. Nate Rodert at 197, 149-pounder Alex Kosher, and Luke Zilverberg at 165 each won a pair of matches to finish fourth. And at 125, Ben Gillette turned in a sixth-place finish, going 3-3. Now, as I mentioned earlier, five Jacks are headed to the national championships. 33 individuals competed each weight in 17 matches Thursday morning. A win earns you a spot in Thursday night's event. Then it's off to the quarterfinals on Friday morning and the semifinals Friday night. And with four wins, you'll find yourself competing Saturday night for a national title. Gross earned the number two seed in the 133-pound weight class. He'll compete against Billy Rappo of Maryland on Thursday morning. Alex Kosher, 27-8 at 149 pounds, is unseeded. He'll take on the eighth seed, Patricio Lugo of Edinburgh. Luke Zilverberg drew the early match at 165. He'll have to face Tyrell White of Columbia in order to make the round of 32 and a match with the sixth seed Daniel Lewis. Moving on to 174 pounds, 23-8 David Kosher will wrestle the number five seed. That's Mark Hall of Penn State. He has just three losses. And at 197, Nate Rodert, the number nine overall seed. The Spearfish product is 21-7. The first round opposition for Rodert is Daniel Chade of North Carolina. The Division I Wrestling Championships open up this Thursday inside the Scott Trade Center in St. Louis, Missouri, and the entire event streamed live on ESPN3. Hats off again to Chris Bono and the five SDSU wrestlers who are moving on to the NCAA Division I Wrestling Championships. Once again, that'll begin Thursday in St. Louis, Missouri. We'll recap the SDSU women's basketball team's performance in this past week's Summit League tournament and talk about their postseason hopes after this week's Jackrabbit Legend.
The greatest single-game scoring performance in SDSU basketball history. Nate Walters' 53-point outburst at Fort Wayne. It's this week's Jackrabbit Legend, presented by Legend Seeds. February 7th, 2013, the Jacks were 18-6, entering a Thursday night league game at IPFW. The Mastodons were four games below 500, but you wouldn't have known by the first half. Fort Wayne shot 50% to SDSU's 32, and the Dons led by 11 early in the second half. Then Mr. Walters turned it on. He scored 15 in the opening stanza, but he posted the Jacks' first 9 points of the second half. SDSU climbed to within three with 11 minutes left, and Walters took over. In the last 10-15, he made three layups, five three-pointers, and six free throws. That's 27 points down the stretch. In fact, counting free throws, he made 14 of his 15 attempts over that stretch. And SDSU needed every one of them, as Walters' eighth three-pointer of the night finally gave the visitors the lead for good. He finished the night with 53 points, a school record, and the most by a Division I player that season. He made 17 of 28 shots, was 9 of 14 from 3, and 10 of 11 at the stripe. February 7th, 2013, the night Nate Walters established school records with 9 threes made and 53 points scored. A Jackrabbit Legend. This Jackrabbit Legend is presented by Legend Seeds, your regional seed leader.
Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. For powerful calls. For breakthrough calls. For professional calls. For tough calls. For unexpected calls. For expert calls. Make the right call. Choose the experts. Choose Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine.
Get ready for the Hefties Fan PhD Tip of the Week, encouraging you to get up, get loud, and get involved, and give the Jackrabbits a hometown advantage.
This year was fantastic. I got my best yields ever.
Record yields start by putting the best seed in the ground. At Hefty, we not only pick the best genetics and traits for you, but we have the most stringent seed grower specs in the industry. That means higher yields for you.
We're Hefties!
And we're big on the farm.
Hefty brand soybeans. Agronomy, answers, yield.
Jackrabbit fans, we've got great venues to have you watch all of our different competitions. Let's make sure we're always respectful to not only the players on the court, the officials, but the fans around us. We never know who's there with us. Let's make sure everybody enjoys the event.
This week's fan tip was brought to you by Hefty's Fan PhD, helping Jackrabbit fans go from good to great. Before we get back to this week's show, here's a look at next week's Insider. The Jackrabbit Insider continues inside Frost Arena, home to the South Dakota State men's and women's basketball teams, the wrestling squad, the volleyball team, and of course, this past week, also home to some raucous crowds for the South Dakota State A girls basketball tournament. Always good to have an event like that right here on the SDSU campus. Well, the Jackrabbit women's basketball team will be returning to the postseason, but they did suffer heartbreak in the semifinals of the Summit League tournament. Let's recap how they fared in Sioux Falls. In the opening round, the Jackrabbit women drew the sixth seed, Oral Roberts, and it was SDSU off to a hot start. Carrie Young scored on the first possession. A minute later, Madison Giebert from three. And a minute after that, it was Giebert again from deep, 8-0 State. The teams would then trade blows, with Young's runner just ahead of the halftime horn, tying the game at 27. The Golden Eagles led by three near the midway point of the third, but the Jacks closed that quarter on a 13-2 run. Ellie Thompson gave SDSU the lead for good with a three. Clarissa Ober chimed in. And Giebert put the Jacks up nine. In the fourth, Young scored 10 straight points to seal it. Four Jacks were in double figures, Young and Giebert with 16, Thompson 11, and Ober 10 points and a career-high 16 rebounds. It was SDSU 65, Oral Roberts 50. On to the semifinals, and a terrific struggle with IUPUI ensued. The two teams who split during the regular season exchanged the lead 18 times alongside 10 ties. Thompson gave the Jacks a three-point lead in the middle of the fourth quarter. Jenna Gunn's three tied it. And after IUPUI regained the lead, Thompson evened the score with three to play. Following a pair of Gunn free throws, it was Lexi Alexander's bucket with a minute to go, drawing the Jacks even at 49. And we're off to overtime. State scored first, Thompson two of her 13. Danielle Lawrence gave the Jaguars the lead, and they opened it up to five with under a minute to play, before Giebert's triple made it a one-possession game. But the Jaguars hit five straight free throws, and the Jacks fall in the Summit League semifinals, 65-61 to IUPUI in overtime.
We had a chance to win it at the end of regulation, didn't quite get it done. We had some shots before that that could have put us up. We didn't quite capitalize. We had an open three. I can't remember what it would put us up. Would have been up four, I think, had we made that three in the corner. We miss it. They go down, hit a three, now they're up two. I mean, there's so many things that could have gone the other way, and our conversation here would be very different. So it happens. It happened to us today. And like I said, IUPUI was deserving. Boy, they hit big shots and played great defensively.
We'll learn the fate of the SDSU women's basketball team later on tomorrow. The NCAA selection show. Jack's clinging to a hope of an at-large bid. If they don't get that, then they'll be WNIT bound, and all those brackets will be released tomorrow night. You can stay tuned to GoJacks.com and follow us on social media to find out the latest on where the Jackrabbit women are headed this postseason. When we return, a special look back at what was a tremendous Summit League championship run for the South Dakota State men. That's coming up next on the Jackrabbit Insider.
Just when you thought the Jackrabbits were dead, here they come under the bright lights in Albuquerque.
To me, sustainability means being able to feed the world in the future.
We need to produce more with less.
It's knowing that our soil is going to be in better shape this year than it was the year before.
We need to stop erosion at the top of the hill, not at the bottom.
We find that we can merge sustainable practices with profitability.
It's about caring for the land.
It's about passing it on to the next generation.
It's about doing the right thing. I have a responsibility
for the people of South Dakota
to feed the world.
The future of farming is very bright.
I'm Jeff Lochner.
Steve Halverson.
Al Muron.
This is farming.
Listen up. This is the time, this is the place, and this is Ford F-150, the truck that goes toe-to-toe with your life. Made of high-strength, military-grade aluminum alloy, it pulled the highest safety rating the government can give. And with Pro Trailer Backup Assist, it's like having your head on a swivel, pal. So load up your crew. This is the time.
Now get up to $10,395 in total savings or lease an F-150 for just $279 a month. Visit your local Northland Ford dealer today.
Jackrabbit Insider is brought to you by the Hefty Seed Company, Agronomy, Answers, Yield. Your local Northland Ford dealers. Visit northlandford.com or your local dealer. Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. Expert care when you need it. The University Bookstore. Shop now at jackrabbitcentral.com. South Dakota Corn. This is Farming. Proud sponsor of the South Dakota Showdown Series. And by South Dakota State University. Be great. Start here.
Welcome back to the Jackrabbit Insider on location inside Frost Arena, home of South Dakota State basketball, wrestling, and of course volleyball as well. Well, the Jackrabbit men won their fourth Summit League championship in the last six seasons, a tremendous run. Justin Hansen and Matt Holland from our department were there shooting some incredible video, and Matt put together this special relive of the 2017 Men's Basketball Summit League Championship. And we'll leave you with this. So for all of us here, I'm Tyler Merriam. We hope you enjoyed the show and enjoy this relive of the 2017 South Dakota State Men's Summit League Championship run.
Winners of six of their last eight, the South Dakota State Men have climbed from the cellar of the Summit League up to the number four seed in this weekend's conference basketball tournament. And now in front of a heavily partisan crowd inside the Denny Sanford Premier Center in Sioux Falls, they look to ride on the back of Summit League Player of the Year Mike Dom to their fourth NCAA tournament in 6 years. It's the Summit League Tournament in Sioux Falls. Telemese at top of the circle, and the three rattles in. Two early threes. He'll work around a dive screen, spin down the lane, short layup around and in. Chris Howell, he'll dribble middle of the lane, spin, right hand hook, nine-footer, good. Dive 30 feet from the rim, will drive him in. High left-hander off the glass, good for two. Baseline. The steal. He races King in, and King with a tremendous Coyotes and fourth-seeded Jackrabbits. Tonight, they meet in the Summit League semifinals. Drive him in the lane, spin three-foot right-hander, good for Rito to use it. Pass, high right, close to Dobb, fadeaway jumper over flag. What a shot by Mike Dobb. Out top, Severin, open three, it's a rounded out, but Tully hews it with a right-hand catch and flushed it back in midair. Back down, Peterson, seven-foot right-hander, it's good for Chris Howe. Right wing flattened for three, it's good. First points for Flatten, and the Jacks have closed it to eight again. Behind the match, dribble against Flatten, leans in, jumper good, count it, and a foul. 7 seconds left, Jacks down one. Orris into the front court, 7 seconds left, five left. Orris left wing, 3 seconds left, 18-footer, good! With 1.4 tenths of a second left. South Dakota State defeats its in-state rival USD. The Jackrabbits survive. The third-seeded Omaha Mavericks stand in front of the fourth-seeded Jackrabbits. It is the Summit League Championship. Antonio's in down the lane. Right-hand floater drops in from seven. And the junior from Sac City, Iowa, has 36 points in the tournament. Dom left wing, long three, and the answer's good for South Dakota State. Morris taken away by Hollins. He'll race King in. King with the block off the board. Tyson up top, an open look for three, and he buried it. Flat right wing for three, and we're tied. Step back straight on three, splash. And South Dakota State has its first lead. Left baseline, Howe in the lane, right hand hook is good. Stumbled, and then jammed it home. Dom flushes it down. Right wing, Howe, Omaha in man-to-man defensively. Dom straight on three. Front end of the 1-1, around and out, rebound Hollins. 6 seconds left, Omaha down two. Hollins front court, 3 seconds left, over Howell, a long three. Banks no good, rebound to South Dakota State. It is a perfect finish to an imperfect season. South Dakota State has won the Summit League Tournament.
These guys, I've felt so close with, the closest team I feel like I've ever been a part of. And I think that's what made it so special was being down, you know, 1-6 at start of Summit League, coming back, being the fourth seed in this tournament and being able to just kind of prove everyone wrong from the start that we had of the season and in the Summit League. And the guys just sticking together. So it definitely was more emotional for us to win. But this team's just so phenomenal. And I love these guys so much.